Hi, my name is Prateep Banerjee. I am a product manager on the Google Play for Education team. I'm excited to be here today to talk to you about Google Play for Education, what we've launched, why we launched it, and what we're launching new this summer. So just to start off, when we built Google Play for Education, we went out and we talked with a bunch of educators to really get a good sense for the challenges that they faced with deploying technology in the classroom. And what we heard from them was four things. First, we heard they really wanted an affordable choice of devices to use in the classroom. They wanted devices in at different price points, with different sets of features, with different form factors. Second, we heard that IT departments really wanted a solution that scales. They wanted a solution that made it easy to provision tablets. They wanted a solution that made it easy to manage those tablets once they were provisioned. They wanted all this in an environment that was safe and secure for student use in the classroom. Third, educators told us that they really wanted to get tools that empowered teachers. Teachers are close to students. They see where they're struggling. They see where they're succeeding. Teachers want to be able to find the content that they need and actually manage which things go out to students. And last, we heard educators wanted a broad set of digital content available at their fingertips, ranging from apps to books to videos that they actually controlled and were able to push out to students when they needed it. So I'm going to walk through each of these areas and talk a bit about what we've done to solve some of these problems. So with Google Play for Education, we've made available a broad set of Android devices. Today, we've actually got a 7-inch Nexus tablet that's available for schools, as well as a Samsung Galaxy Tab for Education. We've also announced that we're rolling out an Asus Transformer, as well as an HP Slate 8 Pro. What this means is that schools can actually choose from many different types of tablets, and when they buy one of these tablets, they know it's going to work within a classroom environment, and they know it's going to work with Google Play for Education. Once you buy one of these tablets, how do you actually get it working in a classroom environment? Many of you have set up Android tablets, and you know that it's multi-step. So you have to add a Wi-Fi configuration, you actually have to set up a username and password, you have to go and download device policy, and then you have to download apps that you want to use on your tablet. This is fine if you're setting up a couple of tablets, but once you're an IT admin that's trying to do this for 5,000 tablets across the district, it actually gets pretty cumbersome. So what we built is this device activation and setup tool. So an admin downloads this tool onto their device, and then all they need to do is NFC bump every other tablet with this admin tablet. And those tablets automatically start setting up Wi-Fi, adding a student profile with a username and password, downloading device policy, and downloading any apps that need to be pre-installed on that device. So then that tablet can be just handed to a student. So what this means is instead of taking days or weeks to set up a district of tablets, you could do that in the matter of hours. So once one of these tablets is set up, how does an educator actually find content for use on that tablet? So with Google Play for Education, what we built is a new set of search filters and browse filters that let educators find apps that align with specific subjects, that align with specific grade levels, that actually can align with specific Common Core curriculum standards as well, if applicable. And the way we do this is that we allow developers to opt into Google Play for Education, and then any app that's opted in goes to a third-party network of teachers that review the app, make sure that the app works well in a classroom environment, and assign metadata to that app that allows for us to surface that app in the right way. So for example, if a third grade math teacher is looking for an app that teaches their kids how to do multiplication, they just look for math, they look for third grade, and they look for a common core curriculum standard that's going to align with multiplication. And they're going to see every single app that exists within the Play for Education store that aligns with that. So once they found an app, how does the teacher actually get this app into the hands of the student? Obviously, a teacher can use a standard distribution mechanism of putting in a student's username and send to a student. But the cool thing that we've done is we actually made the ability to do bulk distribution by having a teacher set up Google Groups for a classroom, for an entire grade, or for subsets of a class. And then when a teacher actually provisions to one of these groups, the app is pushed out to every single student that's in the group. So a teacher could set up a group for basic math students and a group for advanced math students, find apps that make sense for each of those sets of students, and then provision those apps directly to those students, and those apps will just show up on the students' devices. So with the apps that are getting pushed out, we've also built a broad set of management tools that really works for schools. We heard from schools that they really did not want to pay with credit cards. That just didn't work with their buying process. So we built the ability to accept purchase orders. So the way this works is a school sends Google a purchase order, Google logs that purchase order, and then schools can make purchases against that purchase order with the balance declining. And then on a monthly basis, we invoice the school so that they see how much they've spent, what they've spent it on. The cool thing about this is that this happens completely transparently to the developer. The developer doesn't have to know anything about purchase orders. They just know that they sold a certain number of apps and that they get a check in the mail. We've also built tools that allow for teachers to manage the apps that are actually present on the devices. So if a student is done with an app, a teacher is able to use Google Play for Education to remotely uninstall that app, either from a specific student or from a set of students, as well as reassign that app to another student if one student is done with it and another student needs to use it. So no digital content solution in the classroom would be complete without books. So we've actually launched a flexible rental model that has publishers, including top textbook publishers, as well as trade fiction publishers. We've also made available YouTube education videos. So YouTube has a broad set of content that's available that works great in the classroom. Using Google Play for Education, educators can actually find those YouTube EDU videos using the same search criteria that we have for apps and provision those videos to students as well. So what are we launching new? This summer, we're excited to announce that we're expanding availability of Play for Education to Chromebook schools. So for those of you that don't know, Chromebooks are doing extremely well in the classroom environment. In 2013 Q4, 25% of all EDU devices sold were Chromebooks. And over 10,000 schools are using Chromebooks today by millions of students. So this summer, admins of Chromebook schools are going to be able to enable Google Play for Education on their domains, which is going to allow educators in those domains to find the same book and video content that Android EDU schools can find, as well as find Chrome apps that are available in the education space. And all this content can be provisioned and managed using the same management tools that are available for Android schools. The last thing that we're launching this summer that we're super excited to be announcing is the ability for teachers to leave tips for other teachers. What we heard over and over again from teachers is that they want to know what's working for other teachers in the classroom. So what we're enabling now is allowing a teacher to actually leave a tip that talks about an app, what the goals were when they used it in the classroom, how they used it in the classroom. They can link to YouTube videos showing how they used it. They can link to a curriculum or a lesson plan that shows how it really worked in the classroom. So then other teachers that are actually looking for content in the classroom can go read these tips, can learn how this app worked for other teachers with similar profiles, and can really make the app shine within their classroom environment. So what's next? If you're an Android developer that's interested in participating in Google Play for Education, go to developer.android.com/edu. There you can learn more about what it takes to build an awesome K-12 app, as well as understand what the process is to opt in to have your app included in Play for Education. If you're a Chrome app developer, we're not quite ready to accept your app in Google Play for Education yet. We're launching with a small set of developers and a small set of apps, but we're going to be expanding and opening Google Play for Education up to you very soon. Go to developer.google.com/edu if you're interested in learning more about what it takes to build a cool app for the classroom environment and fill out the form that lets us notify you when we have the opt-in process available. If you're an interested Chromebook school, please go to play.google.com/edu. You can actually opt in to start using Google Play for Education right away. And if you're a school that's interested in Android tablets, check out google.com/edu/play. And you can actually learn how to set up Android tablets within your classroom as well. Thanks a lot, and happy schooling.